Welcome to the cookery class of Mom Navera. Today, we're going to explore the world of cookery in the virtual. So, before we start our lesson for today, let us ask for God's guidance. Let's all pray. May I request Andre to please lead the prayer.
Let us all pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Eternal God, Creator of all, we firmly believe that we are in now your presence. We adore your divine majesty and we ask for you to enlighten our mind that we may know and learn you more clearly. Keep us away from the evil things. Bless us with knowledge and understand. Bless our country, especially in this time of pandemic, that we may have fewer cases of COVID-19. Bless us well, my parents, teachers, and the school administrators. We ask this through the intercession of Jesus, your Son. Amen.
All together, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. It is indeed a very warm morning. Good morning, Ten Bonifacio. So how are you today? Did you take your breakfast? Actually, if you don't have any questions, then it's our viewing time. I will show you on how to make a Spanish-style bangus. So when we are talking about Spanish-style bangus, it's not only for a dish, but you can also use this as a business. Okay, so let's go and take a look. A blessed day to each and everyone. Again, my name is Sharon April, and welcome to my kitchenette. For today, I will teach you on how to make a Spanish-style bangus. Bangus, or milkfish, is a type of fish that is rich in fatty acids and omega-3, which is good for the heart. So, let's start. For our ingredients, we have 6 cups of water. We need a chili pepper, 1/3 cup of salt, our olives. We have the preserved olives, that is the Tesco-peated black olives. You can also use the green olives. We have the round pepper, laurel leaves. We have pickles. The pickles is the whole pickles from Ram and have it sliced. We also have carrots sliced into flowers, cloves of garlic that is being crushed, and our 1 whole bangus. Into our milkfish. Other people do brine solution, but for me, the best thing is to have it covered by salt. So we have to put the salt in here, just an ample amount, enough to cover the milkfish or bones. So we just have to cover it. And then after we have covered it, we have to make sure that this is being removed, the viscera are removed from it. And once done, we can cover it with plastic and put it in the fridge for about 20 to 40 minutes. But some people do overnight. Our bangus had been brined already and it's finished. Now, the next thing that we have to do is we have to heat our pan. We're going to do pan frying first. So please take note of the guidelines that we did. In pan frying, we have to add olive oil. And while waiting for it to be heated, then what we're going to do is we have to wash up this fish with water so that it will not be too salty. So let's wash it first. And after washing it, then we have to dry it up with a tissue towel. Now, it had been dried out and it's ready for pan frying. Please take note of our guidelines in pan frying that if it is a little fish, we just need a small amount of oil so that it will be fried evenly. Look at those. We are cooking them so that they will not go into the salt when we have them heated up, when we cook it. We are cooking them so that they will become solid and prevent from dissolving when we try to simmer it later on. Now that we are done pan frying, then it's time for us to simmer our milkfish. We're just not going to use a pressure cooker by this time. It will take a longer hour, but the advisable one is to have it cook in a pressure cooker. So let's do it now. The first thing that we have to do is we have to arrange the carrots in the pan. The slice of carrot should be at a bigger one so that it will not go into melt during the cooking process. And once we have it done, then we can put our milkfish. So see, it's being pan fried very beautifully. After that, it's time for us to add our garlic cloves. Okay, add it. Then we have to add our chili peppers. Make sure that your hands are clean always and you're doing it in a hygienic motion. Then let's have our laurel. After the laurel, let's put our olives. Actually, the olive that will be have to be used is the green one, but since it's not available in the market, I just have it, the black one used. Then have it sprinkled with the pepper. And we have to put the pickles. I often put the sauce of the pickles because it's a little bit sweet and it makes the flavor very good when it comes to it. Okay, so we have to put everything on it. And then we have to add our rock salt, 1 tablespoon. And now it's time for us to add our virgin coconut oil. So this is, or you can also use olive oil. So we can add 2 cups of olive oil. Let's just open the other olive oil. So we just have to pour it here. And we need to measure it so that it will be consistent and balance out. Okay, so since this is just one small milkfish, 1 cup of olive oil is enough. Then let's add water, 2 cups of water. So this is one, and let's add another one, 2 cups of water. There you go. So let's simmer it for 3 to 4 hours. After 4 hours, let's try to take a look on our dish and add a little olive oil to enhance the flavor. And this is ready to serve. Let's do the plating. Now we are done, and we can garnish it to become flavorful and colorful. That's about it. This is our Spanish style balloons, and you can also have it sell in the market for an extra income. Thank you for watching. Okay, so that's how we're going to do a Spanish style balloons. Are you still awake? Raise your hand if you're still awake. Okay, so everybody are awake. Saying good job, good job. Now, since I have taught you already on the different guidelines, now it's your turn to apply it. So I had given you already an advanced assignment for this one so that we can able to check your work. This will be our rubrics for today. So you can able to screenshot and take a look. So we're going to have the food preparation, the palatability, presentation, food value, and of course, that will be for a total of 100%. Let's take a look on your work. So this will be our guidelines in cooking. So I had given you 2 groups already. So in our instruction, so can you please read and greet the instruction?
Create a video showing the guidelines in cooking fish and seafood dishes. Number one, present the ingredients to be used. Number two, state the step-by-step procedures. And number three, your parents' or guardians' rating on the taste and presentation of the fish or seafood dishes.
All right. So let's go ahead and check your work. And this will be the guided questions that you have to answer in preparing your dishes. So I had split you into 2 groups. Let's take a look at Bernadette's group first. So let's see their works on how they do the guidelines in preparing seafood dishes. Okay, so let's take a look. Give me a second. Let's have Bernadette's group. Okay, let's see.
This is the visual presentation of group 2. Today, we're making a simple but delicious recipe of fried tilapia. There are 3 good standby that you wanna know about. One is pan frying, which is already we do now. The other is baking, and the third is poaching. But let's focus on the first cooking method, which is pan frying. So, the most important thing you need to have is the fresh fish, salt, And for the garnish, you need to have is tomatoes, red chili, in plating, you must have at least 3 colors on your plate. Let's get started. But make sure to clean your hands first. So, the first thing you need to do is slice the lemon on either sides of the fish. Second, wipe with salt each fish. Set aside and prepare the pan for frying. Pour the oil to prevent it from sticking. And let's fry the fish in the hot oil.
You can see the guidelines, it's just a little oil.
Follow the following steps for garnish. Surround the fish with your garnish and make a simple dish stand out. Alright, my fish is really well done. Serve and enjoy.
Just like me, they want to be close to you.
Okay, so that will be a great job for group one. That's Bernadette's group. So let's have the grading after we watch Rylene's presentations. Rylene's group, we have Rylene's group next. That is her, that's the group's St. Peter's fish or the tilapia.
All around, just like me, they long to be close to you.
Now let's move on with the next group. So let's have the group of Rylene about buttered salmon.
Have a nice day. That is it. So that would be for Wiley. Great for your presentation. So for your presentation for the group one food preparation, that I'll be giving them 50% and the palatability is 30. For the presentation is 10, and for the food value and content, since it's a deep frying, since it's not that healthy, I don't know what's the oil that had been used, but I'll be giving it 9%. So that's a total for 99% for group number one. Good job. And for the group number two, that's for the food preparation, they prefer Misa and Plus 50%. The acceptability, that's also 30. Presentation is 10. And salmon has a very good content when it comes to fatty acids also, that I'll be giving it 9% also, for a total of 99%. So good job, virtual clap. Come on, I want to see an emoticon of clapping hands. Show the emoticon if you are still here. Clap your hand. All right, very good. Now we are already done and you already perform what we have learned for today. Please write in the chat box your takeaways for this lesson. You can just have one word or two words in the chat box. You can type it. Let's start typing now. In the chat box, please. Let me see your takeaways. Palatability. Ia said palatability. Ingrid said the benefits of grilled fish, fatty acid, the skin skinning to a sharp knife and splitting. All right, so there are a lot of comments on the chat box. So I do think Ryling said nutrients, that everybody got the lesson for today. So for your quiz, I want you to go to Google Classroom for our asynchronous class, and you have to answer quiz number 4. And for our assignment, Ia, can you please read our assignment?
Assignment. Direction: answer the following question carefully. Use an extra sheet of paper if needed. Every item corresponds to 5 points each. Number one, what are the different guidelines for serving fish and seafood dishes? Number two, what is scoring? Number three, why is it important to adhere to the guidelines when it comes to serving dishes?
Okay, so this will be your assignment, and you can see your references at the bottom of the screen. Okay, so those are your references. Take note of that. So that's all for today, Ten Bonifacio. Thank you so much for attending the class. That was a really fruitful and productive class. Hope to see you again next time. And these are all our references. Thank you. Stay clean, stay safe, and stay at home. Bye for now. Bye, Ten Bonifacio.
Bye, po, ma'am. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you.